Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Dress code.
Oh, it's in my bag.
Well, why aren't you wearing it?
What, my bag?
Your clothes!
Give me a second.
Oh, whoa, whoa. Yeah, go, go. Tuck that shirt. Tuck that shirt. What do you think you're doing? This ain't art.
Blockbuster!
Are we really gonna do this every day? I mean, I've seen federal agencies look for nuclear bombs with less wantonness than you're explaining right now. Sir? I mean, what are you even looking for, anyway?
Movies. Aha!
It's a book that you read with your eyes.
I'm watching you.
Oh, hall monitor. That's what you don't understand. Everybody's watching me.
Robin, my boy. How you doing?
Oh, I'm all right, Rick. What's going on?
Nothing much. You know what? I think we need to go on a walk.
Why, wait, hold on. Let me finish this game. I'm playing Clash Royale.
Yeah, well, doesn't look like you're very good at it. No, saw a great movie yesterday. Schenectady, New York by Charlie Kaufman. I actually think it's the best movie ever made. Now, I know what you're thinking. You say that about every movie that you watch every 2 months or so.
You do that.
That's, you know, valid. But, come on, I feel differently about this one. It's really got me thinking.
Why's that?
One that's got me thinking? I can do better.
Sure you can. Oh, wait, how's, what's your movie called? Bill's Blockbusters.
Bill Blockbuster's awesome movie, and, you know, we ran into a few, you know, snags with the budget. Turns out you can't really do special effects when all you have is like $20 in a bag of Skittles, but I think I have a new idea.
What is it?
Because one of the biggest problems we had with that movie was figuring out how to start it. You know, how do you start a movie?
Uh-huh.
You start off with the hero? That's a little cliche. Oh, you start off with the antagonist. It's more interesting, but maybe not. He isn't that fleshed out. Oh, wait.
What about the sidekick?
No, you idiot. You start off with the hot, funny, awesome side character, even if he doesn't appear significantly until the second act. And that is how I'm choosing to start off my next movie, Schenectady, New York 2. I mean, come on.
You would get copyrighted for that.
Let me be happy.
That's gotta wait, because I'm late for AP Euro.
You don't even have a watch!
I gotta go.
Okay, well, see you later. I have to figure out how to avoid copyright law.
All right, boys. One, two, three. Nice, nice. All right, good. The administration is gonna love this.
Oh my God, Ryan, thank you so much for this opportunity, man.
Bro, come on, man. Don't worry about it. This place is awesome. You're gonna love it. It was great to meet you. All right.
It was excellent meeting you too, Ryan.
Okay, see you, man. Bye. All right, dude. We got announcements. We gotta go. We're late.
Yeah,
so
I
got.
Oh my God, you're Ryan Irving. Can you sign my poster? Please.
Sure. Yeah, man.
Thank
sure,
you, man.
Sure. Did you see the show?
I did. It was
you
really
it?
Good.
Bro, yeah. you should join FPTV. It's awesome.
I'll consider it. Yeah.
You should consider it.
Thank you.
Okay. Yeah. I'll see you in a minute. We really gotta
wait,
go.
Wait, Ryan. Wait. I'm a big fan of Ramblin'. I live in Irvington. You know the town that is named after you.
It's not really named after me. It's just the name of the.
Your name of the town.
Ryan Irving.
I
just feel like they're different things. But all right, it was good to see you, man.
Wait. Are you that guy on the billboard?
You put the billboard out already? Dude, I thought that project wasn't due in 2 weeks.
I didn't think it was gonna end.
Oh my God. Alright. We gotta go.
Yeah, come on. I gotta.
Why are they so obsessed with this guy?
Good morning, Fordham Prep.
Good morning, Fordham Prep.
Good morning.
We'll be fine. Just
what are you doing?
I promise I'm gonna get changed right after announcements. I swear.
Announcements? No way. Shorts and a t-shirt? Since when do we ever come to school like that?
I don't know.
Look at him. Perfect.
He's always perfect.
ID, let's go.
Fine.
About time I caught you.
Why the dress code? All right, shorts, t-shirt. Listen, man, I had 6 a.m. breakfast with Olivia Rodrigo. All right, I had to look my best. I'll just get changed after announcements, okay?
I mean, I wouldn't want to disappoint Olivia Rodrigo.
Ready?
Absolutely.
All right, here we go.
Good Monday, April 24th, 8 a.m.
Let's start off with a prayer. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Lord, as we begin a new week, please open our hearts to those around us.
No running during the prayer.
Let us foster a community that allows us to look past the
difference
divide us and be open and welcome to all. Allow us all to take up the call of your discipleship and spread your love and justice
to make the world a better place. St. John the Baptist,
pray for us.
St. Ignatius,
pray for us.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
You can't scan in here, you're late. Go to the attendant.
And now
the
mom,
I'm only a minute late. I'm one more point, I'm gonna get jumped.
I'll get
the sign-ups for the Galapagos trip are due next week. Please turn in the form from the email to
me. I heard that!
The movie club will be having an emergency meeting, trademarked pending, in the theater during third period. Be there or be square.
Athletics, Alex Macho scored a victory-deciding goal in the triple-header game against Xavier on Sunday.
Go Rams! After their phenomenal performances of A Few Good Men, Les Mis, Guys and Dolls, and The Outsiders, the Dramatic Society is in the process of considering what show to put on next. All we know is that it's certainly going to be a sight to see. In other news,
student government will be conducting elections this Friday, April 28th. If you're interested in running for president, please sign up with your name using the sign-up sheet at the dean's office by 3 p.m. tomorrow.
In other news, today will be the last day the Ram for a Day program will be operating this year. We
welcome all newcomers to Fordham Prep. Whether it's academics, sports, clubs, service, or even the Dramatic Society, there's something here for everyone.
Because the Prep is more than just a school. It's a home. It's a community. Filled with students and faculty not only available, but enthusiastic to help out.
This home is open to everyone, even if you come from somewhere far away, even if you're here for something different, and even a little bit later.
Have a great day, Fordham Prep.
I'm not late. I'm only negative minutes early.
Hubri, thank God. The world is ending and we need your help.
The world is not ending. They're just all freaking out because they didn't know we had a test today.
I mean, I did it. It was a long reading about the French Revolution, though.
Like, I did it as well. These guys did it.
Who posts work on a Sunday? What kind of teacher does that?
You know, guys, I mean, this is just common knowledge, but in like 5 minutes, if he's not here, we can just go.
It's actually 15 minutes.
Fight me, bro.
Good morning, AP boys. I've got the answer sheets for this AP test. Are you ready?
Mr. Williams, could you please move the test?
Jack, your AP students, you are prepared for this. I'll be right back.
Hubri, you gotta sit next to me. Come on. You gotta put the answer sheet at the side.
Jack, I'm not helping you cheat.
Please, I have a C in this class. If I don't pass, my parents aren't gonna let me go to Galapagos.
Fine. But if we're doing this, we're doing this my way. The Hubri way. Here's everything you need to know about the French Revolution. Wait, Hubri, how the heck are you supposed to review? He's gonna be back any second. And that's why you, Robin, are gonna distract him.
Me?
Yes, you're the only person who did the lesson. You don't need this.
I did do that lesson.
Wait, but how am I supposed to distract? Just go out there and make something up. Come on.
I don't know.
Robin! 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 Robin!
Okay, fine. I'll go.
Start studying.
Okay, so we have the estates general. They
right,
are actually elect this guy.
His three different
ropes, three different estates.
He has brain of the first
estate, which is
random, left, right,
and third, and he is regular. Right? So, and that's...
Oh my goodness.
Robin!
Mr. Williams, I'm so sorry.
What is going on here?
They're oppressing the third.
He's got a test! No! Hey!
Alright.
Yes, what's up?
Where even is the French Revolution?
What's the deal with this King Louis the 12th guy?
Not King Louis the 12th, King Louis the 16th. And he was basically spending so much money that he made France bankrupt.
I was just wondering, what is this test on?
I think he probably deserved to fail.
Yes, do we get cake after this?
Anybody else?
And then Napoleon!
Have I got a test for you guys? Are you ready? Because here we go.
That's the French Revolution.
Gentlemen, ready to rumble.
Nice job, Hubri.
Dude, that was so close. I don't know what we would have done without you. Like, my AP world grade would be in the depths right now if it weren't for you, bro. Corey, like,
it's no problem.
Corey,
thank you, man.
That's
no problem. It's all good.
He's just doing his job.
Yeah.
I got it last week.
I have no length of time.
For real.
All right, I'll be right back. I'm gonna just go to the bathroom.
I got you.
Hey, what's up, bro?
What's up, dude?
Alright, bro. What's up, guys? You running again?
Yeah, I'm running.
Oh, thank you. I mean, you got no competition, so I don't see why you're running, bro.
I don't know. I mean, if anyone wants to come and challenge me, they can.
It's not gonna matter. It's not gonna matter.
Hey, okay. Yeah, you know. It's only one, probably two, you know?
Guys, thank you. I appreciate it, bro. I do it for you guys. So. What's up, man?
So, do you guys have plans after school or anything? You know, so we can all hang out sometime? Get together with guys better?
I don't know. May go to debate practice later on.
Oh, no, that's cool, that's cool. You know,
We'll see. We can hang out at different times if not, you know?
Alright, that's cool.
What's up?
What's up,
Mr. Prez?
You're Hubri?
Yeah, Hubri.
Oh, it's good to meet you.
Yeah, I've seen you, man.
Oh, this guy saved my grades. I'm telling you. We were in class, teacher's gone for like 30 minutes. He went on a tangent. I, like, without him, I wouldn't be going on this globulus trip. Let me read you. He's him.
Him?
He's him. Yeah. Hubri Way follows his him.
Thank you.
He's him?
Wow.
He's him.
Alright, I'm gonna run to the bathroom real quick, but then after that we can talk about globgos, you know, making plans after school and stuff. I'll catch you guys later.
Oh, you're going on the globgos?
Yeah. That's why, you know, I try to get a good grade.
Oh, my dude. Alright. I'll see you in a minute.
Okay.
That kid's got no brain at all.
None. None.
He's thinking about going on the Galapagos. He's lucky he doesn't fall in the volcano.
Oh, I was at Applebee's once with him. He knocked into a waiter, and she spilled all the food everywhere. What a bozo. I've heard he's so stupid that he cheats in all his classes.
Guys, don't you think this is a bit, mean? He's not even here.
Who cares?
Whatever.
You gotta get used to this kind of table. It's life, you know?
He will do literally anything if you dare him.
I know.
It's embarrassing half the time.
Guys, so, that, as I was saying before, I was in the bathroom. Galapagos, I'm sorry for this trip. Like, don't even get me started.
You sound ready. Did you submit the form and everything? All the stuff?
It's due this week, isn't it?
It was due last Friday, man.
Dude, last Friday?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I thought...
Right, well, better luck next year, dude.
Maybe you could talk to one of the counselors. But
I don't think that'll help. Nah, that's not gonna help.
That form and... But it is what it is. You know, it's fine.
Yeah, next year, dude. Don't worry.
Yeah.
Okay. Where are you going?
Bye, I guess.
Okay.
Thank you.
Hubri.
What up?
Isn't it interesting how the Galapagos forms were due Monday, next Monday, at 3?
Yeah? What about it?
Exactly.
Well, Hubri, you see that toaster over there?
What are you talking about, man? There's no toasters out
here. No. When I found out that toaster wasn't waterproof, I was shocked.
That's the dumbest joke I've heard in my entire life. You ever feel like people just suck sometimes?
I mean, I guess. But I know some people that don't. Here, come on, follow me. I know what'll cheer you up.
You know, I was so excited when I got that email this morning that said the movie club will be having an emergency meeting in the theater, third period. And you know, I've been excited for this for this opportunity for such a long time because I've had this idea, you know, sprouting in my mind about a student who runs for class president. He's gonna learn about like Machiavelli and like you guys know like the term like the ends justify the means and all that kind of stuff. So basically, you know, he sees something wrong with like the system at school, the establishment, you know, the student who's already president. He kinda sees like the real him, the fake and the flaws inside of him. And he's like, you know what? I'm gonna do better and I'm gonna bring this school to revolution! There's gonna be three acts. First act, you know, we're introducing Ford and Prep and everything. Second act, you know, he's doing the actual election and stuff like that. And he does like all of these Machiavellian things along the way to win. Like he tries to get like a smear campaign and stuff like that. And in third act, you know, we have the actual election and there's like tons of twists and turns and it's gonna be absolutely crazy. I mean, what do you think, Rick?
Lucas? coming up with movie ideas, you know, it's not for everyone. And that's okay. You know, some people are better at it than others, and that's fine. I just feel like this is missing a little something, you know?
You know what I mean? You know, Rick, I was expecting you to say that. And that's why this movie, right, we're going to call it The Election of Hubri, and it's going to have this crazy side character in it, played by none other than Rick Blockbuster. And he's playing himself and he's got all these like these movies, these pirated movies that he's giving out to the movie club. And there's this guy who's like constantly chasing him the entire time, the hall monitor. And this is no way based in real life at all. This is all from my mind, original. All this stuff is completely original.
There's a platform named Hubri.
Yeah, I was gonna say,
look,
actually.
That's completely a coincidence, you know. I had these buttons made already. I'm sure you guys are hyped for this. You guys are gonna absolutely love this. You know, take a button. You know, pretty awesome. Like, everybody, look at this button.
Wait, but this is Hubri on the...
Yeah, I was...
I had a graphic designer make this all on his own. You know, we didn't have anybody for inspiration. This is a complete coincidence.
The photo, it seems like he's posing for
it.
Yeah, I was...
You see the color? Do you see the color? You see the color on this? Like, this is not a real person. This is just color. And, you know, I had somebody draw it.
No, it's a striking resemblance.
I feel like I've seen this guy before, right?
The photo company on the back.
That part isn't important.
Yeah.
The part that is important is that Rick Blockbuster will be playing one of the main awesome side characters.
Okay. Disregarding everything about the pins, this does really sound like a great idea. But logistically, how are we gonna make this work?
So I was looking at the schedule, and I was thinking we could have auditions today. I mean, if that's okay with the whole like movie club meeting, you know, and you guys can be like the casting proofer. You have a question?
So if I audition for Hubri,
you can play Hubri, yeah.
But the pins
are.
We can change the pins. This is just it's a prototype, you know. So it's just a prototype. And I was looking at the schedule, and I was thinking we could like film this in the coming weeks, you know, you guys, the cast and crew and everything. And then, you know, we may have to film after seniors leave, but if you guys would be willing to come back for that, like, we could totally...
That barely became to school.
Okay, Lucas, you can sit down. You're good. Okay. Does anyone have, like any actual ideas?
No.
No one?
Blank slate.
Okay, well, I'm glad. This is actually a good thing, because I have come up with, dare I say,
the best idea that has ever been had in a Rick Blockbuster emergency movie meeting trademark pending. Ever. Okay? This is everything we're looking for. It has a little something-something. It has a plot engine that'll drive us firmly to the third act. It has everything that we need in a movie. Okay? It is called... Ryan Irving the Movie.
The Ryan Irving?
And the Ryan Irving is going to be coming to this Rick Blockbuster emergency movie meeting today.
You're joking.
I'm not joking. Oh my God. I'm not joking. Okay, obviously, I don't need to tell you why this is exciting. But first, Jesse, my movie pitching best.
Of course.
Now, Ryan Irving, friend of the community, should be showing up right now.
What?
Oh, hey, Robin.
I didn't think I was going to see you until the second act.
Oh, could I have my phone back, by the way?
Whatever. They're tricky. Anyway, here you go.
What's your name?
Hubri.
Hold on a second.
Hubri. Right.
What?
Okay, well, anyway, friend of the community, Ryan Irving, should be showing up, any second now.
No, he's not here.
Woo!
Danny Lang, everyone!
players,
there's something you maybe want to tell us?
I wish I didn't have to. How are you, Rick?
I'm nice doing great!
What's going on, boys? Nice to see you all.
I was told that Ryan was going to be here!
I actually just got a message from here. Let me check. Yeah. Ryan will be unable to attend. He's actually attending to children with the Make-A-Wish Foundation. So he sent me here.
Oh,
nice to see you all.
But Danny, I had so many ideas. Look at this. I mean, okay. So Ryan Irving the movie. Right, come here. Come on.
Do I want
to
look?
Yes, yes, you need to. Okay, so act one, you know, we're establishing the world of Ryan Irving, and we establish that the College Board is bad. And then, as is very important, Ryan Irving eats a burrito, and the burrito reveals to him that he has to fight the College Board. I have no idea how I'm going to make that work, and the logistics are still unclear, but I absolutely think that that's going to happen. And then, act two, he realizes he can talk to squirrels, and the squirrels help him beat up David Coleman, the CEO of College Board.
Uh-huh.
But then, he realizes that the secret College Board leader is actually Peter Canali, who's an inside plant meant to spy on Ryan Irving in his years at Fordham Prep. And then he releases all this information that he's gathered on a solo episode of Ramblin'. And then, oh my God, Danny, the big twist is that Ryan realizes that he was a robot all along,
what?
Created by the College Board to spy on the squirrels of Fordham Prep.
You're a maniac.
No, I'm not
a maniac.
You call me a maniac now,
me?
You will watch the movie and you'll realize that it is the most perfect, the most
grand,
the most incredible idea in all of cinematic history. You're
are
insane.
You kidding me?
You're crazy.
I'm crazy.
I refuse to admit that this
you're
isn't-
You're a psychopath,
that this
you're a maniac,
exactly what needs
you're
to happen.
Creating this entire
you're,
film
you're,
around
oh,
this
oh,
one
I'm
kid's
Danny
life.
Lang.
He's a normal kid.
I hate Ryan Irving.
He's
I hate fun. I hate joy.
Life.
I hate love. That's what you sound like. That's what you sound like.
You're unhinged. You're unhinged.
I'm so hinged. I'm so hinged. But Danny, oh my
Danny.
God.
Danny. Please. We even-
What?
No.
I spent half of my life savings. I made a Ryan Irving bobblehead.
This is who's leading you?
I
this
kid?
That? Yeah. Are you serious? This
yeah.
is unhinged.
Guys, come
this
on!
This is what I'm talking
yeah.
about.
Yeah! Ryan Irving!
And you're depriving us of this?
Yes! Ugh. Yes, I am!
I spent half of my life savings on this, which means that I only have $25
what?
Left in my bank
what is,
account.
What is he doing with this?
He's singing! That's like his thing!
Whoa.
This doesn't even look like him!
You are insane. You don't belong to be here. You need to understand. This matters so much to me, and I need this to happen. You need to talk to Ryan. You need to make something.
No, I'm
work.
Not. I'm not
Look,
talking
so,
to nobody.
It's so cool.
Are you kidding me?
I mean, it's already. Hey,
what is he even doing?
Give it back. Look, this is important. This is important to me. This is important
this
to them.
This thing should
you
never
understand?
See the light of day.
Give it back, okay? This is important.
I'm gonna need that right now.
You
give it back
cannot
to me right
do
now.
This to me. You cannot.
I got it.
Yeah, get it. You got it. Don't! Yes! Yes! Jesse!
Here.
Yes! I'm so proud of you! Run! Run!
That's it! I'm done with this! James! I can't whistle!
Gentlemen! Blues! You there! Stop! Stop, Roger! Stop! Sit down! Now! What in God's name is going on here?
Nothing.
I wish I knew.
Are those movies?
No. No, no, they're not. These are Xbox. You can see by the distinctive green.
Or this
Xbox.
One.
Xbox.
Or this
Let
one.
Let me see those. What are
right
you smuggling?
Here, take these two.
Synecdoche. You uncultured rube. This is why nobody likes you.
What the hell is it?
New York!
What is that?
That's the state you live
oh.
in!
Oh! Magnolia, the election of who the hell's Hubri? What, and
actually,
what the,
I'm kind of unclear.
You're
about
making
that
these poor kids watch on
they
a tiny little
thing. Why aren't you replying? Oh, hey, oh! Oh, ridiculous!
Yeah. Yeah.
Blockbuster! Why aren't you projecting?
Wait, instead of making
it was a whole
thing,
you just plug in the projector
into
the Ryan Irving himself.
What the
is
heck happened?
Avid
to the outlet.
Look,
there's two
of
them
the moment,
still in there.
In the heat of the moment, I got a little caught up. Okay, I got a little worked up when I realized that the Ryan Irving, which who you were supposed to provide, was not going to be here. I got a little agitated. Okay?
A little,
maybe more than a little. And I'll allow that.
What do you mean you'll allow it?
I'll allow that criticism.
There's two of them still stuck in the outlet.
Well,
touch it.
I don't want to touch it.
Don't. Is this what came out? This is what came out, and you're condoning this. And he's laughing.
This is pretty
cool. All right.
I don't know what to tell you, man.
For destruction of property.
What?
Oh, and everything's falling apart.
No.
See what you've caused? That's it. That's it.
No!
Oh my God.
You can't arrest him.
That's
no.
It.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, boys.
Hold him.
Okay.
Here.
Hold
him.
I
got
him.
I got him in here.
I see how it is. I bravely and boldly decided to speak the truth.
James.
Meanwhile,
doesn't need him
you are trying to silence me in any way that you can. Boys,
don't talk to them.
Movie club. Wait for me.
Don't talk to them.
Please.
That's
enough.
I put
Robin in charge.
What's happening?
Robin in charge. I know that he just left. And I know that he's
kind
of, he doesn't really care about us that much. But I really need him to lead us. He's the most charismatic one here. Fellas, that's enough. Please. That's enough.
Fight for me even still.
Shut this down.
Come on.
Please.
Have prevailed.
Remember me. Your hands off. Please.
Yes.
Take a seat.
Nothing.
You can't silence the people.
Nothing. Take a seat, gentlemen.
I just want to make you.
This has no business seeing the light of day.
You started something.
I mean, it does kind of look like it.
Yeah!
James, get him!
Get back! You can't keep him forever, you pig!
Well, welcome back to FP News. I'm one of your hosts, Ryan Irving, here with my other host right here.
Danny Lang.
And today we have a very special guest for you guys. You know him, you love him, Corey Lead. Give it up.
Corey Lead, nice to have you.
Now, he's one of our most high-profile guests. For those of you guys that don't know Corey Lead, he is the sophomore class president. I believe he's been the president for, what, the entire year of sophomore year?
Yeah.
But not only is he the class president, he is Fordham Prep's very own renowned AP World Scholar, taking our History Bowl team to a number one national championship. I mean, Danny, I don't know if anyone wants to comment on this, but I was walking in the halls the other day, and I swear that I heard people just chanting Corey's name.
I mean, I would too. I couldn't tell you anything about AP World, let alone be number one.
They just chant his name. I've never seen anything like it. But, you know, enough with the small talk, because you're here on AP News to share some news, all right? The people have been talking. Rumors have been flying. All right, we're walking through the commons and we're seeing these sheets of paper on the door to the Ministry Center, as Danny's illustrating.
Yes.
And it's showing the students who are running for class president. And at the very top, we have the name of Fordham Prep, the name everyone knows, Corey Lead. Now, Corey, from our end, it seems like you're pretty much running for this unopposed, you know what I mean? So we would love to hear just a comment about your presidency, what you're feeling going into it.
I'm excited to run again this year. I hope we have a good election. But, actually, I have a few words to say. if you don't mind.
Certainly, go ahead.
Right ahead. Thank you. To anyone out there who may be watching, know this. Any of you could be doing this job, but you chose me. And for all that, for that, I continue to serve you with my greatest possible extent of my power. I will make this school the best it could possibly be for you. I will fight to my utmost hardest to make this place a better home for you. I will stay up until the darkest hours of the night, working to ensure you that not a single one of you are left behind. I will tear through the jungles of bureaucracy to save you from the extra day of school. I will plow through the mud to make sure that you are recognized for all of your achievements. And I will never back down when I am approaching you or protecting you from these terrors of this world. I'm Corrival Raspick Lead, and I am your president. And to anyone else who may want to challenge that, who may think that they can do a better job than me, I welcome you. Let the games begin.
This guy is so full of it.
Corrival!
That cheered you up, right?
Yes.
What are we gonna do?
Cut to three establishing shots for the hot lobby. You just unlocked a new area. The election of Hubert.
Here on this map, Rick looks incredibly disappointed.
No, no, no!
Wait, wait.
But I've already established.
Jeez.
What was that?
Ryan Irving. You're a psychopath. You're a maniac.
You're creating this entire
film around this one kid's life. He's a normal kid.
I hate Ryan Irving. I hate fun. I hate joy. I hate love. That's what you sound like.
That's enough. Please, that's
please,
enough.
Please, even still.
Shut this
come on,
down,
Marvel
please.
Heads
have prevailed. Please.
We start a movie, and then we go throughout. We go through the hallway,
and they eventually cut his.
He's got a test. No.
Blockbuster.
Why aren't you wearing
from a bag?
Your clothes.
You know, you love him before you leave.
Give it up. You ready again?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Alright, good. The administration's gonna love this.
Look at him! He's perfect!
He's always perfect.
I mean, it does kind of look like him. Alright, boys. One, two, three. Nice, nice.
Okay. I mean, I wouldn't want to disappoint Olivia Rodrigo.
I'm personally excited for the movie. It's gonna be a good one. I hear the main character's a cool guy.
Isn't there supposed to be like a green screen kind of thing? Don't worry about it. I'll fix it in post on my AI.
Alright.
No. Put your hands down. People find you intimidating when you point at the camera.
Trust me, it's the Hubri way or no way at all.
I guess you're doing the Hubri way.